अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टडीड कूलम्स लॉ ऑफ फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन टू चार्ज, अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्शन बिटवीन द टू चार्जेस विच आर प्लेस एट अ फिक्स्ड डिस्टेंस। दैट फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज found to be directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, and it is given by the equation 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 if the two charges are placed in air or vacuum into q1 q2 upon r square. This is the mathematical expression of Coulomb's law. So from here, now we are going to define charge of 1 coulomb, means we'll have to define the unit of charge. So this is what our topic, definition of unit charge from Coulomb's law. So here we have stated the Coulomb's law that this force of attraction or repulsion is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r square, where Q1 and Q2 are the magnitude of the charges which are placed at a certain distance. Suppose these are the two charges, Q1 and Q2. They are separated by a distance, say R. So how we are going to define? Suppose the two charges, Q1 and Q2, they are of 1 coulomb. Because we will have to define the 1 coulomb. So let us say Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to 1 coulomb. Suppose they are of 1 unit or 1 magnitude, and they are separated by a distance r, means the distance between these two charges r is also 1 unit, means 1 meter. So what comes in the formula? F will becomes force of attraction or repulsion between the two charges is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, as Q1 is 1, Q2 is 1, and R is also 1. So this entire quantity, this will become 1 unit. Hence the force of attraction or repulsion between the two charges will be exactly equal to 4 pi epsilon 0, where this epsilon 0 is the permittivity of a free space. Remember that we have placed the two charges in air or in vacuum, you can say. Then the value of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, this value empirically or mathematically, its value comes out to be equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. The value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, the constant of force of attraction or repulsion, this value comes out to be equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. So put this value in this equation, we will get our entire force will be exactly equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. So what happens when we take the two charges which are of 1 coulomb and we separate them by a distance of 1 meter, the force of attraction or repulsion between the two charges become 9 into 10 raised to 9, which is quite high, 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton. So in the same way, we'll have to define the charge of 1 coulomb. You can say that 1 coulomb is the amount of charge which, when placed at a distance of 1 meter from another charge of the same magnitude in vacuum, experience a force of 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton. So 1 coulomb will become the unit of charge when it is placed at a distance of 1 meter from the other charge of same magnitude and experience a force of 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton. So this is the definition of 1 coulomb. Let us again define it. 1 coulomb is the amount of charge which, when placed at a distance of 1 meter from another charge of the same magnitude in vacuum, experience a force of 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton. So quite simply, we can define the unit of charge. Now let us solve one example on it. Example 10.2. The statement of the example is like, charge on an electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. We all know it that the charge on electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Such a small value it is. 10 raised to minus 19 of the coulomb. How many electrons are required to accumulate a charge of 1 coulomb? Means, one electron is having this many charge, this small charge. So, lots of electron will be required to make a charge of 1 coulomb. So, let us solve how many electrons are required to make a charge of 1 coulomb. So, we all know that one electron is corresponding, its correspondence charge is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So, let the total number of electron which contributes to 1 coulomb of charge be n. So, let us say n number of electrons are having a charge of 1 coulomb. I am repeating the statement, one electron is having the charge 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. N electron is having a charge of 1 coulomb. That n we will have to determine that how many electrons are going to make the charge of 1 coulomb. This is simple cross multiplication between these two equalities. So, just cross multiply it, 1 electron into 1 will become 1 only, and n into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So, n into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 is equal to 1. Then n is equal to 1 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. This ratio comes out to be equal to, actually this ratio comes out to be equal to 0.625, and this 10 raised to minus 19 will come in the numerator to become 10 raised to plus 19. So, I can write this 0.625 as 6.25 into 10 raised to 18. So, 6.25 into 10 raised to electrons are needed to make a charge of 1 coulomb. Because one electron is having such a small charge, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Now, let's move further. Till now we have studied the scalar form of the Coulomb's law. Now, if you are asked to show the direction of the forces also, how you are going to show it? So, let us study the vector form of Coulomb's law. So, the next topic is Coulomb's law in vector form. Here we have taken two charges which are positive in nature. The both the charges are positive. It means what? There will be a force of repulsion between the two charges. Charge Q1 and charge Q2. These are the two charges which are separated by a distance. Let the distance between the two charges be R. So when we draw one line from the charge Q1 to the charge Q2, it will be in the vector form, it will be written as R12 because it is directed from charge 1 to charge 2. Similarly, if I draw a line between the two charges from charge Q2 to Q1, it will be written as R21. Vector R21 is a vector which is directed from the charge 2 to the charge 1. Distance between them is constant, but their direction is different. You can say in the right hand side, the vector which will be used for the direction will be R12, and for the left hand side, the vector which are going to use is R21. So, charge Q1 will be repelled by the charge Q2, as we all know that there is a force of repulsion between these two charges. So forces of repulsion between the two charges, and obviously we will have to measure the distance between the charge, and we'll have to measure this distance from the origin. So here we have taken our coordinate system x-axis and y-axis. The distance of charge q2 from the origin is r2, and distance of charge q1 from the origin is r1. So here we have taken two distances also. Now how you are going to write down the Coulomb's law? Let us first write down the Coulomb's law in scalar form. So how we are going to write it? The forces of attraction or repulsion between the two charges is equal to, suppose the two charges are placed in air. So this formula will become 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r square. This would be the formula. Now obviously, how many forces are there? Two charges are there, so two forces are there. Force experienced by the charge q1. The charge q1 will be repelled by the charge q2, so the force of repulsion will be directed in this direction. Force of repulsion experienced by the charge q1 is directed in this direction. So it will be written as F12. One is the number which denotes the charge which is experiencing a force, and 2 is the number which denotes the charge which is exerting a force. So here F12 is the force experienced by 1 and exerted by second charge. So this F12 is directed in this direction. Similarly, charge Q2 will also experience a force exerted by Q1. It will be directed in this direction. So it will be written as F21. 2 is the number of charge experiencing the force, and 1 is the number of charge which is exerting a force. So both the forces F12 and F2, as shown in the diagram, they both are oppositely directed. How you can show it in a vector form? So here I will write the distance between the two charges. R is constant, so this is just a magnitude of the force. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r square. It is just a magnitude or Coulomb's law in a scalar form. Now if I want to write down the equation for this force F12, F12 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r square into. Now what I have to do, I'll have to involve the direction of the force as well. So the force is directed in which direction? It is directed in the direction of r21. The vector r21 is drawn from 2 to 1. This is the direction of r21, and the force F12 is directed in this direction. So this force is actually directed in the direction of r21. So now I will have to multiply it with a unit vector of r21. Unit vector is denoted like this. This cap denotes that this is a unit vector, means a vector which is having only direction and its magnitude is 1. So our Coulomb's law will not be changed. The only thing will be added over here is direction. Its direction, this expression shows the direction of the force, because this R21 is having a magnitude equal to 1. It is a unit vector. Similarly, if I want to write down the equation for the force experienced by the second charge exerted by the first charge, it will be written as F21, which is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r square. But this time our unit vector is going to change. Now this time the F21 is, see here, it is directed in the direction of r12. So here I will have to take unit vector of r12. Now say this one as equation number 1, this one as equation number 2. Now from the diagram we all know that r12 is directed in this direction while r21 is directed in this direction. Both the vectors are oppositely directed. One is along the positive x direction, other one is along the negative x direction. So what I can write is r12 bar or r12 hat, you can say, they is equal to minus of r21 hat. Unit vector of 1,2 is opposite to that of unit vector of r21. So these two are opposite. So what will happen? The two forces from equation 1 and 2, they will also become opposite to each other. F12 bar is equal to minus of F21 bar. Both the forces are opposite in nature, because both the forces are force of repulsion. So this is a vector form of a Coulomb's law. Now let us solve one example. Example number 10.3 of your textbook. This example says that calculate and compare the electrostatics and gravitational forces between the two protons which are 10 raised to minus 15 meter apart. This 10 raised to minus 15 meter is the distance between the two positively charged proton. Value of capital G. Capital G is the gravitational constant. Its value is also provided. It is 6.674 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter square per kg per second square. And mass of the proton is also given to you, 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27 kgs. Now what we will have to do, we'll have to calculate the electrostatic force between the two protons. We all know that there are two protons which are positively charged. The distance between the two charges are given. Charge on one proton is same as the charge on one electron. We all know it. It is 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So these two charges will experience the electrostatic force of repulsion, and as these are the two point masses, these are the two points which are having a certain mass. See, the mass of the protons are also given. It is 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27 kgs. So whenever there are two masses which are separated by a certain distance, the gravitational force will come into account. You might have studied about the gravitational force. So you'll have to calculate electrostatic force of repulsion between the protons and gravitational force of attraction. So let us first calculate the electrostatic force. We all know that electrostatic force Fe is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R square, where Q1 and Q2 are the magnitude of the charge, which is proton. It is having a same charge as that of the electron, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And distance between the two proton is also given. It is 10 raised to minus 15. And the value of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is known to us. It is 9 into 10 raised to 9 newton meter square per coulomb square. So put all these values in this equation. We are going to get at the place of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. We have placed 9 into 10 raised to 9. Into at the place of Q1 we have placed 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. At the place of Q2 we have placed 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 divided by R square. Distance is 10 raised to minus 15. So 10 raised to minus 15, after squaring it will become 10 raised to minus 30. 10 raised to minus 19 into 10 raised to minus 19 is 10 raised to minus 38. So 10 raised to minus 38 will be there in the numerator and 10 raised to minus 30 will be there in denominator. So 10 raised to minus 38 and this 10 raised to minus 30, when it comes in the numerator, it will become 10 raised to plus 30. So 10 raised to minus 38 and 10 raised to minus 10 raised to plus 30 will become 10 raised to 8 only. 10 raised to minus 8. 10 raised to minus 8 and 10 raised to 9 will become 10 raised to 1. So here we have done the calculation for all the powers of 10. Only 10 raised to 1 will remain. Now do the calculation for the rest of the numbers. 1.6 into 1.6 is 2.56. Into 9, when you multiply it, it will become 2.3 into 10 raised to 2 Newton. This is the electrostatic force. Now let us calculate the gravitational force. As we all know that gravitational force is equal to G into M1 M2 upon R square. It is same as the Coulomb's law. Both the forces are similar, almost similar in mathematical expressions. So gravitational constant is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. Masses of the proton, we all know that it is given in the question. It is 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27 into 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27. And this 10 raised to minus 15 will, it is again having the square, it will become 10 raised to minus 30 in the denominator. When it comes in the numerator, it will become 10 raised to 30. So when you calculate all the powers of 10, 10 raised to minus 11 is there, 10 raised to minus 30 and 10 raised to minus 27 into 10 raised to 30. From the denominator, when 10 raised to 30 comes, it will become 10 raised to 3. 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to minus 27. 3 more will be subtracted. So it will become 10 raised to minus 24. 10 raised to minus 24 into 10 raised to minus 11, it will become 10 raised to minus 35. 10 raised to minus 35, when you do all the calculation, you are going to get 18.6. When you multiply all this number, you are going to get 18.6 into 10 raised to minus 35. In 10 raised to minus 35, one point, if I want to shift, it will become 1.86 into 10 raised to minus 34. Now I will have to compare, because it is mentioned in the question that you'll compare the electrostatics and gravitational force. So comparing both the forces, Fe we are having the value and Fg we are having the value. So Fe divided by Fg is equal to 2.3 into 10 raised to 2 divided by 1.86 into 10 raised to minus 34. This 10 raised to minus 34, when it comes in the numerator, it will become 10 raised to 36. So 10 raised to 36 will be written as it is, and 2.3 divided by 1.86, this ratio comes out to be equal to 1.23. So our answer is 1.23 into 10 raised to 36. So in this way, we can solve the forces of attraction or forces of gravitation between any two particles by knowing the values of the charges and masses and their distances, and knowing the values of constants 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 and gravitational constant. So hope you'll have understood the topic. Thank you.